body grows bigger.
Your mind was slower. It's great to learn.
Because knowledge is power.
In Schoolhouse Rocking, a chip off the butt of your favorite Schoolhouse. Schoolhouse.
Good morning, class. I'm your new teacher, Miss Myrtle. Oh, that was terrible. Okay. Good morning, class.
I'm your new teacher, Miss Myrtle.
Oh, that gets worse. I can't believe it. I'm so scared. I'm terrified. I love teaching. I love children. I know I can be a good teacher. Who are you?
I'm your conscience. And I am here to reassure you that you have everything that you need. All you need is just a little confidence. Let's start at the beginning with the people, the places, and the things.
Well, every person you can know, and every place that you can go, and anything that you can show, you know their mounds.
Oh. A mound's a special kind of word. It's anything you ever heard.
The train. I was wishing I was back home again. I took a train to another state.
Well, every person you can know,
like a bandit or an engineer,
and every place that you can go,
like a state or a home,
and anything that you can show,
like animal, plant, or a train,
you know their nouns, you know their nouns.
Oh, I took a ferry to the Statue of Liberty. When in the middle of summer it started to snow, when I took a ferry to the Statue of Liberty.
Well, every person you can know,
like a friend
or the captain of a ship,
and every place that you can go,
like an island
or the sea,
and anything that you can show,
like a statue,
a ferry, or snow,
you know they're nouns, you know they're nouns.
Oh, I put a dime in the drugstore record machine. Oldie goldie started playing, if you know what I mean.
If you know what I mean, I heard
Chubby Checker, he was doing the twist. And the Beatles and the Monkey thing goes like this, yeah.
I put a dime in the drugstore record machine.
Well, every person you can know,
the Beatles
and the Monkey, Chubby Checker.
And every place that you can go,
like a neighborhood or a store,
and anything that you can show,
like a dime
or a record machine. You know they're nouns. A noun's a special kind of word. It's any name you ever heard. I find it quite interesting. A noun's a person, place, or thing.
A noun is a person, place, or thing.
Okay. I have to quit daydreaming. Get ready for my first day of class. I really don't have time. I've got lesson plans to do. It's going to be a tough day.
Myrtle, Myrtle, it's not going to be that tough. It's going to be quite easy. In fact, it's going to be as easy as 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
3 is a magic number. Yes, it is. It's a magic number.
Somewhere in the veil of ancient history,
you get 3 as a magic number. The past and the present and the future, faith and hope and charity, the heart and the brain and the body give you 3 as a magic number. That's a magic number. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30. Do that with me.
3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30.
Now multiply backwards from 3 times 10. 3 times 10 is
30.
3 times 9 is
27.
3 times 8 is
24.
3 times 7 is
21.
3 times 6 is 18. 3 times 5 is 15. 3 times 4 is 12. And 3 times 3 is 9. And 3 times 2 is 6.
And 3 times 1. What is it?
3.
That's a magic number.
One, two, three, it's a magic number. Oh my, that was one cool song.
Cool, hot, snappy, jazzy. I can think of lots of adjectives to describe that.
Adjectives. What are adjectives?
Places and every last thing. So we unpacked our adjectives. I unpacked frustrating first. Reached in and found the word worst. Then I picked soggy and. Next I picked foggy and. Then I was ready to tell them my tale. 'Cause I'd unpacked.
I can teach just about anything with a little imagination.
Right. Grammar is just a lot of words, a train of words, hooked together to make one long train of thought. In fact...
My job done.
The junction, junction, what?
sort of the opposite.
Not this, but that.
And then there's or.
O-R.
When you have a choice like this or that.
And button or gets you pretty far.
Something like this choice, either now or later, or no choice, neither now nor ever.
Hey, that's clever.
Eat this or that, grow thin or fat, never ever would I do that. I don't wanna be fat.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
Hooking up phrases and clauses that balance life out of the frying pan and into the fire. He cut loose the sandbags, but the balloon wouldn't go any higher. Let's go up to the mountains or down to the seas. You should always say thank you or at least say please.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
I'm hooking up words and phrases and clauses and complex sentences like in the mornings when I'm usually wide awake. I love to take a walk through the gardens and down by the lake. Quite often she had Dot and the Drake, and I wonder as I walk by just what they'd say if they could speak. Although I know that's an absurd thought.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
Hooking up cars and making them function.
Conjunction, junction, how's that function?
I like tying up words and phrases and clauses.
Conjunction, junction, what's that function?
I'm gonna get you there if you're very careful.
Conjunction, junction, what's your function?
I'm gonna get you there.
After that song, I think I'm ready to teach some English.
Well, Marty, you have to remember, English isn't the first language of many of your students.
That's true. I've got a lot of children from other countries and cultures.
Now remember, you have just as much to learn from them as they have to learn from you.
My grandmother came from Russia, a satchel on her knee. My grandfather had his father's cap he brought from Italy. They'd heard about a country where life might let them in. They paid the fare to America and there they melted in.
Lovely Lady Liberty with her
also by the Spanish, Dutch, and French. The principle still sticks, our heritage is mixed, so any kid can be the president.
You simply melt right in. It doesn't matter what your skin, it doesn't matter where you're from or your religion, you jump right in to the great American melting pot. The great American melting pot. Who would have stood?
The new world and Europe was the old America.
The making of America wasn't always that easy.
I'm not quite sure what you mean.
The United States of America didn't always reach from sea to shining sea.
That's true. We sure have had our growing pains.
Ready?
One thing you will discover when you get next to one another is everybody needs some elbow room. Elbow room.
It's nice when you're kind of cozy, but not when you're tangled up and nosy. Oh,
everybody needs some elbow.
Needs a little elbow room.
That's how it was in the early days of the USA. People kept a-coming to settle, though the East was the only place there was to go.
The President was Thomas Jefferson. He made a deal with Napoleon.
How'd you like to sail a mile or two?
Or three, or 100, or 1,000?
And so in 1803, the Louisiana territory was sold to us without a fuss and gave us lots of elbow room.
Room they ever had.
The way was opened up for folks with bravery. There were plenty of fights to win land rights, but the West was meant to be.
They call it manifest destiny. The travelers, traders, and the peddlers, the politicians and the settlers,
they got there by any way they could.
Any way they could go.
The gold rush trampled wilderness railroads spread across from east to west. Soon the rest was opened up for good.
Now we check from east to west. Goodbye, New York. Hello, LA.
But it took those early folks to open up the way.
Now we got a lot of room to be growing from sea to shiny sea.
Guess that we have got.
I've got to teach science. Ugh. I can see teaching grammar. At least you can put it down on paper. But how do you teach something you can't see, like the solar system?
Well, now remember, you travel by train, you travel by plane, and you've even traveled by boat. A spaceship can't be that different.
It's a gas, hydrogen. I should give it a go. But the creatures on that planet look so very weird to Janet. She didn't even dare to say hello.
It's a bird. It's a plane. Why, it must be UFO.
Mystery.
But you're gonna be okay. You're gonna be wonderful, terrific. It's gonna be okay. Have a good day.
When Reginald was home with the flu, the doctor knew just what to do. She cured the infection with one small injection. By an exclamation point.